Our final inductee into the 8th Annual Class in the Cannon Courier Hall of Fame is Mr. Chad Sleepy Thomas. A member of the Cannon County High School Boys Basketball Team from 1994 to 1998, Chad became a starter his junior year. Thomas would be a key player for the Lions his junior and senior seasons, helping bring what was called a Los Angeles Lakers Showtime like atmosphere to the offense. God, I wish I could have seen that. He went on to play at Volunteer State. Today, Thomas works for the Murfreesboro City Schools as a computer tech. Another Hall of Fame member, Mr. Alan Bush, will present Chad Thomas in this year's Hall of Fame class.
I'm a little disappointed. I had a video and for you guys over here. Y'all know what VCR is? For real, y'all know what it is? If I had to get an old VHS tape out, and I was sitting over here thinking about it, and I thought, man, they may not have what I need to show this today. And then I got to thinking, I know they had one, Mr. Francis Ramhead video, Mr. Burks, no video, so I don't feel too bad about not being able to show that. But if you'd have, I was able to show that, you'd see some of the, I guess, the Lakers Showtime, some of the dunks that Sleepy had during that. I threw some of that up on Facebook, so maybe some of you guys will get to see that there. But first, I think I speak for the community when I say thank you to the Hall of Fame Selection Committee for honoring Chad. I think he's a very deserving young man. And my association with him obviously came from being able to coach him. I got to coach Chad in middle school and high school. I got to watch his growth as not only a player, but as a young man. And just being around him, which I'll get into in a second, but just, he's just a good guy. If you know Chad now, you know he's a good guy. And I'll get into that in a second, but I actually even asked, I contacted Brandon Burks there, who was on the staff, and Mr. Knox up there, who was on the staff, and coached with me at the time, and I said, hey, y'all got any bad stories on Chad? Something I can just, you know, make fun of him for? And like, one of them was like, that's a tough one. And I was like, I don't know, I'll think about it. I never heard back from him, so I don't have anything bad to tell on him, and that's a good thing. But he, Chad, when I coached him in high school, I was very fortunate to be there and coach there when there was a lot of good players, and hopefully a lot of those guys will be getting inducted pretty soon. But you know, he was always in the gym. You know, if you heard of the term gym rat, he was in there constantly. Had to run him out, but if you ran him out, he was going to the park. Just played all the time, worked on his game all the time. That's why he became as good as he is. I don't know many guys that probably played basketball as much as he did. It didn't turn out to be a good basketball player. And he put an enormous amount of time into it. And like I said, he was around a lot of other guys that were good players that were gym rats too. I've been coaching a long time, and I never remember being around a group of guys, and you got Mr. Knox and Mr. Burks both can remember this. But man, been around guys that just played all the time. We even played with them, just in the gym constantly. And that's why they were good, why not being very good. And when Chad asked me to do this, I was proud, humbled. As I was putting some thoughts together, put some things down on paper about some things to say about him, I could sit here and talk about basketball not long, but the one thing that kept coming back, which I kind of already mentioned a little bit, was character. You guys probably heard this, but J.C. Watts, you know, he defined character. He said, you know, a lot of people try to define character, but character is doing the right thing when nobody's looking. And that was Chad. And, you know, like I said, as good as a basketball player, he's a better person. Well, a lot of you guys maybe don't remember, that's kind of why I was wanting to show a video. A lot of you guys, and actually, Terry, your brother managed to show one last year. I thought, I didn't do that, but I didn't call ahead and get as prepared as I need to be. But for some of you didn't get to see him play or know much about him, I'll throw a few stats at you here. As a junior, he was selected to the All-District Honorable Mention team. As a senior, he missed several games over the year because he broke his wrist, which is pretty devastating to him at the time, obviously. But as a senior, he was selected All-District first team. And oddly, he was part of the first team. Kennedy County High School went to, when it was built in 70, help me out, 8, 9? All right, if we moved to double A. Okay, which moved a little, got attendance went up, enrollment went up a little bit, so we moved up a little bit. So had some good basketball teams through the years, but he was part of the first team that ever won the district 7AA tournament. We actually won the tournament his senior year. And for some odd reason that year, still to this day don't know what happened, but coaches must have voted that we weren't doing an all-tournament team. Had an all-season team, which he was on first team, but we didn't have an all-tournament team. He'd been the MVP of the tournament. Still to this day, I don't know what happened that year. It's the only time I ever remember seeing a tournament where they didn't have an all-tournament team. So, Chad, you're MVP. I'm going to go ahead and get you. But it was to watch him play that year, it was pretty impressive, especially in that tournament. He just went on a roll. He went from averaging about 11 points a game to about 18 and a half to 19 points a game in the tournament. Had some dunks, and we won every game by double digits and just kind of rode to the district tournament. But also, he was selected to the All-Better Youth Journal team. He was All-Region Tournament. He was voted the team MVP that year. We went to Daytona Beach for a tournament. He was the Sunshine Classic All-Tournament and Slam Dunk Champion. That little dunk contest in the middle of the tournament, he won that. Went on to play collegiately at Volunteer State Community College. Where he's voted team captain both his freshman and sophomore years. He averaged 10 points a game his freshman year, 11 points his sophomore year. He then later on played in the WBA, which is the World Basketball Association. He played for the Mississippi Hard Hats. He was injured and only got to play a few games that year. Then he played in the ABA, which is the American Basketball Association. Played for the Georgia Grizzlies, started the majority of the games and averaged about almost 7 points a game. He, I guess to sum some things up about him, Chad was not the fastest kid by any means, but he was one of the most determined players. So in other words, whatever he lacked speed-wise or whatever, he made up for with his determination. Maybe he'll tell you, I can't count how many hours he spent playing basketball, but he loved it. And like I said, he was fortunate enough to be around a bunch of other guys that loved it. They reap the benefits from it. But I'm honored tonight to induct Chad. Chad, congratulations.
All the coaches I've had at every level, you're still the best coach. I'm thankful that you opened those gyms all this time. I'm sure we aggravated you to death. to be asked to stand here today is an honor. This might be the best recognition as far as basketball I've ever received. One thing close to this to me is maybe that district championship. I've been truly blessed. I'd like to thank also my mom and dad and their support. They travel all over to watch me play. My mom is a big big influence. She's a 1,000-point scorer herself and made it to a state tournament. So I'm very thankful for all my teammates. As he mentioned, I had a couple of guys with me, Ryan Timpany and Zach McAllister, after 8 hours in the gym with me. Ryan Timpany is still to this day one of the best point guards I've ever seen play here. I'm pretty sure we stayed in the gym so many times, we ordered pizza a couple times. Just had to deliver right to the door. But yeah, I want to thank all my former coaches as well, Coach Brandon Merks, Coach Tim Knox. They were huge. Coach Teddy Taylor, I don't know if he's here or not, but.
Here. Oh.
Also want to thank, I grew up playing with some great players. When I was a freshman coming in, a senior, Willie Davenport, was a huge influence on me because he was one of those guys that stayed in the gym. And I wanted to be as good as he was. I wanted to mentor his game. So he was a huge influence. The times we played Auburn Town, I played with Johnny Neely, another big influence to me. Those two guys are legends. Matter of fact, Tara, I think you beat me up a few times at Auburn Town, so I appreciate that. Learned a lot from you. I'm truly blessed to grow up here in Canada County. Everybody's always been supportive. We have some of the best fans. I remember going to we went to that Sunshine Classic in Florida, and it felt like we were the home team. Our crowd was just, we probably had more people than all the teams combined. So I'd like to thank everyone I had a hand in putting this event together. Thank you for everybody that nominated me and voted for me. I'm truly honored. Thank my family and friends that supported me. And finally, I'd like to congratulate my fellow inductees and the students are here tonight to accept their awards. I wish you all the best of luck in your careers. But it's an honor to join all those who have come before me, and I can't wait to see what's next for Canton County. Thank you.
That concludes our evening. I want to end by saying congratulations to our student athletes, award winners. You make us proud, very proud, each and every one of the individual sports accomplishments and scholarships that you do. To our inductees, Jackie Francis, Estelle Parker, Catherine Reed Mohan, Ronnie Burks, and Chad Thomas, congratulations to you. You're entering a very esteemed group of people if you just take a look at the back of your program and see. But all so, so deserving. And the courier and staff at First Bank, I think I can speak on their behalf, are proud to be able to offer this event and honor those of you for what you have done in your careers, whether it was in the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000, and the years to come. Congratulations to each and every one of you. I would also be remiss if I didn't thank Mindy Gunner, our friends at First Bank, Morgan Lester, Dan Lester, is that right? I got that.
Alexander.
Huh? Alexander. Somebody wrote this down wrong. And his wife, Jessica. I got that right. And Ben, it's so good to see you again. Thank you so much for your participation in this. Keith, thank you for your hard work, even though some of your notes were wrong. What we would like to do, I'm going to ask all the Hall of Fame inductees and their presenters as well as the first bank presenters to remain for photographs afterwards. Students, you can hit McDonald's if you wish, if you haven't had enough barbecue already, but we're free to go unless somebody has somebody else that they'd like to bring up and talk about. All right, obviously there's no I team members here tonight, so. With that said, congratulations to everyone. We stand adjourned. We'll see you next year. Be careful driving home. God bless all of you.
Thank you.